They say no campaign don't call for one better touchlight in the ministry's department and join body them. One MP said they no gree submit their financial report, give the office of the Auditor General of the Federation. The campaign one MP said be one coalition of pro-transparency group. They won't make a touchlight the matter of those who MP said they do work out for the joint body for them well, and made the federal government sanction them well too. Members of the campaign one MP said they young give talk men inside Abuja don't call the action of the MDAs as breach of laid down rules and regulation and attempt to promote Wuruwuru.
Interestingly, 11 parastatals were reported to have never submitted their financial statements or audited financial reports to the office of the AGF since their inception. Yet, they have continued to enjoy resources appropriated by the National Assembly and the Office of Budget and National Planning for this number of years. We find this hugely irresponsible and unacceptable. It directly indicts not just the defaulting parastatals, but also the National Assembly and the Office of the Budget and National Planning as complicit in this ongoing fraud.
We call on the anti-corruption agencies to be proactive in responding adequately to this damning allegation and take necessary action to hold these officials and their agencies responsible. We demand that erring CEO should be sanctioned and made to submit all outstanding financial reports, which should be thoroughly scrutinized by the Office of the Auditor General. We call on the President Muhammadu Buhari to caution his ministers, push them to be responsible, and sanction the ministers responsible for defaulting MDA. The names of defaulting agencies and their chief executive officers be published and full investigation to commence by the anti-corruption agencies.